So my riding story started out before I was even born. My mom was a hunter and a jumper, and so was my great-grandmother. So they pretty much started out for me and pretty much, like, paved my road to riding, you could say. So my mom was a super big thing back in her day. She rode in circuits all around the U.S. and everything. She stopped riding for a little while and then got horses again soon after, and she bought me my first pony, whose name was Scooby, and he was just the cutest little thing ever. He was a little Welsh pony, and I adored him. I actually fell off of him and didn't get back on a horse until 4 or 5 years later when I got Snickers and started lessoning. So in that 4 or 5 years I didn't ride, I still loved horses, and I, like, every time I went to petting zoos, I always rode, like, those little miniature ponies that, like, went around in circles. I was obsessed with them. So, like, in that time, it was kind of just a blur. I don't really remember exactly what happened. I do know I got Snickers the Christmas of 2014, and I started messing around with her then and starting to, like, train her, or at least train her as much as I could at that age. And then there was kind of just a blur. I don't remember exactly what happened. I know I got Abby in that time. It was just a big blur. I don't honestly remember. I fell off Snickers, broke my elbow. It was just a big thing. In August of 2015, I started taking lessons at a local hunter barn where I lived, where Chloe lessoned, and a bunch of people I knew lessoned, so I figured I'd start lessoning there as well. The first lesson I had was on a horse named Murphy. We pretty much only walk trotted, just normal stuff, because I was still getting my confidence up after having a super bad fall the year before and breaking my elbow. And then soon after that, I started riding the cutest little mare ever. Her name was Gilly. She was just freaking adorable. She was my favorite lesson pony. I just rode her as much as I possibly could, and I pretty much took all my lessons on her. Eventually, I did outgrow her. Don't seem to matter anymore. They led me here to you. I know that it's gonna take some time. Got to admit that the thought. So after I outgrew Gilly and I couldn't move up on her anymore, I started riding this horse named Santos, and he was a big 17 hand. I'm not sure his breed, but he was huge. He had the bounciest trot you could ever think of, but his canter was smooth as anything. So I pretty much did all my lessons cantering on him. We barely trotted because I was just terrified of my eck while I trotted, and I was just too scared to get it built up. With him, I pretty much did like 2-3 courses and stuff, cross rail bounces, just normal stuff. So I only took a few lessons on Santos before I started feeling like I didn't fit into the hunter world, or at least at that barn. The girls there that rode there were just high-end hunters. They made me feel super bad about myself, and I was just like, okay, I don't want to ride here anymore. So I took 2 months off, and then I eventually found Eskimo, and I'm sure you guys all know him. He is the greatest little pony you will ever meet. So I started riding Eskimo in September of 2015, and he was by far the greatest horse I've ever ridden to this day, except for Abby, of course. So for the first few months I knew Eskimo, I actually did not ride him consistently because there was another girl who was riding him before me, and she was still riding and competing him for the rest of that show season, so she had first dibs when it came to him. When the new show season came though, I officially like had him as my own, you could say, and I was able to consistently ride him whenever I wanted to, I could show him whenever I wanted to, and things just really started kicking off for him and I. The thought has crossed my mind, this might end up like it should. And I'm gonna say what I need to say, and hope to God that it don't scare you away. I don't wanna be misunderstood. So Eskimo is like the most bomb-proof safe horse you would ever meet. He jumped anything, he went over anything, and he did anything you asked him of. So because of that, it really built my confidence as a rider, and when I was riding him, I always felt like I was like on top of the world, you could say, and I was just like so good when I really wasn't, but like, it's the thought that counts, I guess. So he really grew me as a rider. When I rode him, I jumped my first 2-6 jump, my first 3-foot jump, my first really big oxer. We just had a lot of firsts together, and I'm just like so happy I had the chance to ride this freaking amazing gelding. So Eskimo also took me to my first show on February 13th of 2016, where we came home with champion, reserve champion, 2 first place, 3 second places, and a 3rd place, and it was just the best show I could have ever asked for. Our back number was number 309 for the rest of that season, so like to this day that number means so much to me. So the girl who rode Eskimo before me actually did barrel racing on him, so I took a little dab in it, and we did our first show and came home with 2 seconds, 2/3, and 2/4, and it was just a freaking blast. So on May 22nd of 2016, Abby was moved to Smoky Ridge where Eskimo was boarded at, and she was there from May to about the end of July, beginning of August as like a birthday present for me. In the time Abby was there, her and I really both grew together. We learned to trust each other a lot more, and our, like, bond together just grew, like, immensely. I started jumping a lot higher and really gaining confidence and everything. Went to our first show, and it was a complete disaster. We actually only came home with one fifth place ribbon, but I was just happy that I finally got to show my little white bean. So on August 13th of 2016, Eskimo and I went to our second to last show together, and it was an emotional day knowing I'd only be able to do this one more time with him, but we did pretty well. We came home with a first, 2 seconds, a third, and a reserve champion, and I was just super happy with him because the last show before that was just a complete disaster, and I felt like this was a really good comeback for it. Yeah, I'd rather be a lover. So after that show, I started taking lessons at the barn Chloe was lessoning at. I only took like 2 or 3, and I started riding Abby a lot more because I was going through a really super hard time in life, and I just like felt like my horse was really the only place I could go to be safe. So in that time, I really started training Snickers as well and really focusing on her and getting her going as a pony. So then on October 7th, Eskimo and I dressed up as Snow White and Grumpy for the local Halloween show, and then we also had our last show of the season the day afterward. We came home with 4 seconds and a reserve champion, and I was just really happy with him for that being the last show of the season, and it was a really emotional day for me. So after that show, I rode Eskimo on and off for the next couple months. I think I only rode him like a few times after that because I started getting Abby going, and then I ended up moving, and just a bunch of stuff happened where I didn't have time to get out and ride him as much as I really wanted to. So it was really hard knowing that our time was coming to an end because I had to bring another horse up and like having to end the lease with the horse that pretty much taught me everything I know. But I do thank God every day for giving me that opportunity to ride such an amazing gelding and really grow as a rider with him. And I still do see him every once in a while. I don't ride him as much, but I do see him and keep up with him and see how his progress is going because he's back in barrel racing. And I'm just really happy that I got the opportunity to ride him. So in January of 2017, Abby and I joined Pony Club. I had been looking into Pony Club for the past few years, but my mom finally found a Pony Club where I lived that I could join. And then on March 18th of 2017, Abby and I went to our first rally ever. It was a dressage rally at Poplar Place Farm in Georgia, and it was just one of the best experiences I ever had. So after that rally, I didn't really ride Abby as consistently. I didn't do very many Pony Club meetings or really anything after that because the thought of moving was up in the air, and I kind of was just like focused on that and figuring out what I was gonna do. So after that, I really didn't ride as consistently or like as productively, I guess you could say. So this isn't really considered my riding, but in April of 2017, I went to Rolex and I met Caitlin, Jill, Regan, Maddie, and Claire, and they were all my idols at that point and still are my idols to this day. And I also met Boyd and Ryan and a bunch of riders there. And after Rolex, I really decided I wanted to be an eventer. And from that point on, I really set my foot in the door and I was like, okay, this is what I'm gonna do. So then in May of 2017, we moved Abby down the road to a barn because Snickers was out on trial and Noni was in training and she was at our house alone. So we moved her to a barn with other horses so she wouldn't be sad. And then from that barn, she came back home when Snickers came back off trial and the people decided they didn't want her. And then from then on, we moved down to Florida. So in July of 2017, we moved down to Florida, and once I got down there, I really started competitively riding, getting on a consistent schedule, and getting Abby back into shape, and it was really a good time for me being able to keep my mind focused on my horse. So we did our first show on August 13th. It was just a pop schooling show. We came home in second in entry combined training and then third in the intro dressage test B. It was honestly a disaster of a show, and after that my mom and I agreed it was time for me to find a trainer. So then on August 26th of 2017, I went to my first Pony Club meeting at my new Pony Club and completely fell in love with everybody there. I was really excited to be able to meet new kids where I lived and make new friends to ride with and to really have good opportunities to get my riding going. So in between this time, I started lessoning with my trainer, Amanda, and I started lessoning twice a week consistently, and she's the one who brought me schooling, cross-country schooling for the first time. And with her, I've really learned to be more of an independent rider for myself and really learn what to do, when to do it, and really starting to become an eventer and build my confidence up. So then on October 21st, 2017, Abby and I went cross-country schooling for the first time, and it was the best experience I've ever had. I was so excited, and like it was just so much fun for me. And then the day after, we did our first beginner-novice combined training and came home with a second place. And after cross-country schooling was when I really decided, like, yes, I want to be an eventer. And then I really started pushing myself to be a better rider and to really get there. So the beginning of November, I really focused on my dressage a lot more. I brought Abby to a clinic with my pony club and Noni to the clinic as well, and we really focused on that a lot more. I started lessoning more and really just like focusing on becoming better. We didn't really do much. The month of November didn't show at all, but I was just really focusing on getting better. And then on November 26th, we went cross-country schooling for the second time at Rocking Horse Stables in Ocala. So then on December 2nd of 2017, Abby and I went to our first entry-level three phase. We scored a 42 in dressage, which wasn't the best, but I felt I did my best and did rode the test well. We had one rail in stadium, but we're good on time. So on cross country, she looked at every possible jump she could, chipped into every possible jump she could, but we finished the course almost clear and safe. She refused the last jump, and I almost came off, but I was like, I'm not coming off in my first three phase, and then I got her back over it, and we ended up 7th out of 13 people in my first ever three phase. So then about 2 weekends after, where we went to another three phase at the Florida Horse Park, we came home with a 34 in dressage in the brand new 2018 test, which is our best test to date. We had a clear stadium round with no faults, and then cross country came. She refused to jump. I went over her head and fell off and got disqualified. I did get her through the rest of the course because I wasn't going to let her give up. And after that, I just really doubted on if she could do it or not and if I wanted to do this anymore. And after that, I kind of just took a few weeks off and didn't ride, gave her a little break, and then the holidays came around. I was up in Georgia, so I couldn't ride, and I was just really questioning on what I wanted to do. So then on December 29th through the 31st, there was a pony club camp going on at the horse park, and my mom and I decided it would be good for Abby and I to go to see where we could like get our confidence back up and if she could do it or not. So we were in the beginner novice group for show jump, but I bumped down to entry level cross country the next day because I didn't feel like I wanted to do beginner novice yet. I was just like, I don't know if I can do it, so I bumped down to entry. We had the best show jump lesson I have had in my entire life. Abby was just on fire. She was awesome. I was really riding like I should have been, and she had no problems with any of the jumps. She went over everything I asked of her, and I was just so happy with her by the end of the ride. I was literally in tears when I was walking back. I was like, I'm so proud of this horse. I would lay in my bed and dream about what I'd become. Couldn't wait to get on. The show jump portion of the clinic was with a guy named John Brown. He was from Scotland, I believe, and I just really loved the way he trained and how he explained things, and Abby really seemed to like him too, and he loved Abby, so I was just super happy with that. The good old days, all the love you won't forget, and all these reckless nights you won't regret. So when the morning of cross country came, I was absolutely freaking out. I was having anxiety attacks, and I was like, I don't know if I want to do this, but I was like, we paid for it, so I'm going to do it. And I am just so happy I made that decision to do it because it really changed my outlook on things. So the cross country portion of the clinic was with a lady named Natalia Nineman. She's a C1, C3 star advanced level eventer, and she's competed at Jersey Plantation Field, Richland Park, and stuff like that. So I was super excited to be training with someone like high-end like that. And she taught me one little trick where if I literally just stand up in my stirrups and I just tell myself I'm going to go over it, Abby would go over it. So Natalia trained in a way that I really understood and I really like took home with me, and she just explained things the way that my mind would process them, and it was just really good, like knowing that I'm actually understanding what she's saying and I know what to do, because sometimes the trainer I'm training with now will say things I don't really understand, and then I get frustrated with myself because I don't understand it. So my mom and I are now looking into training with Natalia for a little while just to get me going, get my confidence back up, because she really teaches me and makes me learn the way I understand, and it's just been really good for me. Like after that one time of cross country with her, I just know like me and Abby can do this now. So ever since then, Abby has had a very well-deserved break. She got about 3 or 4 days off, and the weather started getting cold, so she actually probably had about a week off, and now we're kicking back into gear, we're getting back up, and we're going to start really working on our dressage a lot more to get those scores up. We're going to be going cross-country schooling as much as we can, and we're really just going to be working towards getting better and striving to be better. You don't know what you got. After that clinic, I really like question. I was like, I don't know why I ever doubted this horse, because Abby has been the one thing that's been there for me through everything I've ever been through. She's just constantly there. She wants to please me as much as she can. And I really, like, hated myself for ever doubting her because she really enjoys it. It's just I didn't have the, like, trust in her or anything to let me think that she can do it. And now that I do, I really feel like we're going to go far and that we're going to really learn a lot together and move up a lot more than I ever thought we would. I'm hoping to do my first recognized event before April, or in April, or May, or anything, and I hope to qualify for USPC champs this year and try on North Carolina, so we have some big plans this year and I'm really going to work towards them, and I'm not going to let anything get in my way because I kept letting my mind get a hold of things and really taking me down, and now I understand that we can do it. So I just wanted to come on here real quick and just kind of explain some things after this video. So I know this video is kind of all over the place. My riding recently and through my entire life has been all over the place, but I really feel like now is like the time where me and Abby are going to go places, and now that I have the trust in her and the like confidence in myself to know that we can do it, I feel like we're really going to go really far, or as far as we can, as like together as a team. So I really like am hard on myself to this day on doubting her because she enjoys it so much, and now that I know what I need to do and how to fix it, I really hope I can gain her trust back, and like I hope we can do it. So I wanted to say that. I wanted to thank you guys so much for watching. Sorry this video is so long. I've been editing it for like 3 days and I finally got it finished, so I hope you guys enjoy it. Leave a like and just share some love, because I have been editing this thing for 3 days straight. I was up until 3 a.m. last night reading a book and editing this video, and I just really hope you guys enjoy it. So don't forget to like and subscribe, follow me on Instagram, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Thank you so much for watching. Bye. Just a young gun with a quick fuse. I was uptight, wanna let loose.